Hey everyone, and welcome to this new episode of CodeXYZ. Today, we'll take a look at the three most famous messaging apps currently used in the world: WhatsApp, Telegram, and Signal. And we'll get a better understanding of which one of them is the best. So now I'd like to compare these three messaging applications with three main factors: privacy, security, and features. Let's start with the first one, privacy. Especially after what recently happened with Facebook's new policy, now WhatsApp will be sharing its data with Facebook. But what are the data that WhatsApp is selling through Facebook? If you go into your WhatsApp settings, you should be able to download those data. I did it for my account, and here are some of the data I found. All the groups you're in, all the contacts you message with, the time you're active and inactive on the application, and the model of the devices you use WhatsApp with. There's just a bunch of them, there's a lot more. But all this information are about how you use the app, and they do not contain the content of your messages. For this reason, we'll refer to them as metadata. In my personal opinion though, even if these are only metadata, they can say a lot about a person, and that could make you vulnerable to targeted ads or worse, political actions. Telegram and Signal differ on this approach. None of them is selling data to other companies or using them to create advertisement yet. The reason I'm saying yet is that it seems that Telegram will be using ads inside its channel in order to monetize the product. At the opposite, since Signal is owned by a nonprofit foundation, it's safer to assume that it's not going to look to make financial gains in the future. So it's realistic to expect that they'll never use users' data for advertisement. Let's now talk about security. All three applications have some sort of end-to-end encryption, but if we dig deeper, we'll see that they are on different levels of security. Let's make sure we have clear in mind these three types of encryption, that for today's video we'll refer to them with three different levels, where level 1 is the less secure and level 3 is the most secure. Level 1 is no encryption at all. This means that if our communication is encrypted by a government or a hacker, they'll be able to read it. Level 2 is client-server encrypted. Anyone that intercepts our conversation won't be able to read it, but who owns the server where the conversation is stored will be able to read it. So in the case of an application like Telegram that uses this type of encryption for some of its chat, it means that if they wanted, people at Telegram could potentially read our conversations. And also, if their servers get hacked, there is a chance that hackers will be able to get access to those content. Finally, level 3 is end-to-end encrypted. This means that only you and the person or people you're communicating with can read the content of the conversation. Telegram has end-to-end encryption, which is level 3, only on secret chats. The rest of the conversations are client-server encrypted, which is level 2. This is okay, but not the best, especially since Telegram might be planning to sell ads in the future. My fear is that they might be interested in knowing more about our conversations to show us better ads. WhatsApp has introduced end-to-end encryption across all the conversations and groups. But still remember that all the metadata that I mentioned to you at the beginning are not encrypted. But what Signal is better at than both of them is not only the fact that it has end-to-end encryption on all the conversations and groups, but also the fact that Signal's code is open source and Signal's communicating protocol is public. This means that a lot of researchers and cryptographic experts can review the code that builds the software at any time. This is a huge difference, because it's one thing to say that an app is doing something, it's another thing to let people see it. In addition, Signal is able to encrypt all your metadata. Let's now move to our final category, features. Signal is still lacking on this side. There is a bunch of extra features that are still missing. Some of them include the fact that there is not a web app or the fact that you cannot search for GIFs on the desktop app. But the Signal team is trying to quickly build new features to accommodate all the new users that it got recently. WhatsApp has all the features that you need from a messaging app. The unique features that it can provide that the other two do not have are the status or the stories. This feature sort of gives WhatsApp a social media buy. Finally, Telegram is overloaded with features. It has bots, polls, quizzes, hashtags, and a lot more that can make the group experience a lot more fun. have to say that bots are particularly interesting given the flexibility of how anyone can build them and integrate them with other apps. So my final and somewhat personal conclusion is that Signal is by far the most secure and private app. This is because Signal is adopting security by design, thinking and conceiving every feature by putting the security values first. Telegram has the best experience in terms of how many features it has. Finally, WhatsApp, I think, has a better user experience and is more user-friendly. So I don't think that there is one best app. It really depends on what you care about, if it's privacy, if it's your user experience, or if you need a lot of features. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, please subscribe to the channel. And if you have any comments or questions, just post them in the comment section below.